The Parliamentary Committee on Human Rights today faced off with Security Minister Major General Jim Muhwezi over gross human rights violations waged by security agencies. Muhwezi was questioned on existence of safe houses where suspects are allegedly tortured.
Allegations that internal security organization operates safe houses and that these safe houses are basically torture, ungazetted torture chambers. So the direct question to ask is, to the best of your knowledge, does internal security organization or external security organization operate in a safe house anywhere in Uganda?
In his response, Muhwezi noted that all safe houses were disbanded and phased out in security systems, but he refuted claims that they were used as torture chambers.
You have promised to give us more information because we have had a problem where lists have been given but without details. So it has been very difficult to look around for a person whom you don't know where he comes from.
The Human Rights Committee, chaired by Fox Odoi, the Member of Parliament for West Budama North East, asked the Security Minister to find seven victims of enforced disappearance whom the Uganda Human Rights Commission reported that they have been missing for over 2 years. They include John Damulira, Matthew Kafero, Matthew Chigozi, Sarah Namayanja, Agnes Nawere, George Kasumba, and Ibrahim Chekede. They have not been seen for a very long time.
Sincere on this, who are these people who are doing the arresting? I'm sure they have to be known. For those who are in plain clothes, for those who are covering their faces, and then when they arrest Ugandans, it takes like 1 week, 2 weeks, you find someone on side of the Lord being dropped from there.
The position that we must account for every citizen and alien in our jurisdiction, so we need to work together and find out where these people are.
Muhwezi assured the MPs that investigations into allegations of the seven missing persons will be carried out, adding that the government does not condone illegal arrests and torture.
The president has also guided many times to the organizations, all of them, including police, that there is no need to torture anyone. Now, having said that, there may be individuals who make mistakes and commit crimes, which I have mentioned. But whenever these are found out, they are punished.
Appearing before the same committee, the Attorney General Chiriowa Chiwanuka defended use of infamous minibus vehicles, popularly known as drones, in arresting suspects. But the committee asked government to provide details of security agencies that are authorized to carry out arrests using drones without number plates.
That was called drones. Because the view of the people of Uganda is that it's the people who torture citizens, who drive numberless Toyota Hiace vehicles, and they arrest people without identifying themselves and torture them. So interest yourself and supply to the committee at a much later time the security agencies that use or are associated with those vehicles.
The Attorney General also disclosed that 3 billion shillings has been spent in 2 years to compensate torture victims. He says all the perpetrators of torture who have caused losses to government are going to be brought to book.
Specifically for enforcement of human rights, in these often protracted processes, we have had the Minister of Justice pay out in this period that we're talking about 3.5 billion shillings to victims of human rights violations. Honourable members, this is not by any standard a thumping of the chest by government to say that they have done very well. Our intention is to bring this figure from 3 billion to zero. Our aspiration is to ensure that no monies are paid out to anyone who is a victim of torture, because the idea is there should be no torture.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.